Hello everyone, welcome to EduTap. And guys, this is your lecture number 14 in your revision series. If I talk about our previous results, guys, in NABARD graded 2019, we have 25 selections out of 41 seats. In grade B 2019, we have 4 selections out of 8 seats. And in RBI grade B 2019, we have 215 plus call interviews. If I talk about our results in 2018, we have 26 selections out of 46 seats in NABARD grade A. In SEBI grade A 2019, we have 41 selections. And in RBI grade B 2018, we have 72 selections out of the 127 seats. If I talk about today's lecture, guys, today I will be covering GA in news, that is mostly related to February 2020, reports and indices. And then I will be covering a Niti Aayog annual report, which was released recently. So let's start with our GA, and that is our first question. Recently, which of the following personalities has been appointed as High Commissioner of India to Canada? So let's see how many of you are getting your answer right. And the answer here is, that is Mr. Arvind Krishna. So Mr. Arvind Krishna has been appointed as High Commissioner of India to Canada. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following countries has hosted a high altitude fashion show and created a Guinness World Record in February 2020? Yes, most of you are participating today, and let's see how many of you are getting your answer right. The right answer here is, that is, guys, that is Nepal. So recently Nepal has hosted a high altitude fashion show and it has created a Guinness World Record. So moving on to our next question. Which of the following state is the theme state at the 34th Surajkund Craft Mela, which has taken place in Haryana? Now guys, right answer here is, that is Himachal Pradesh. So you have to tell me two more things. Where this Surajkund Mela has taken place? And the second thing is, which country is the partner state in this Surajkund Craft Mela? So guys, Surajkund Craft Mela takes place in Faridabad, that is in Haryana. And the another important thing is, the partner state here is, the partner country is, that is Uzbekistan. So moving on to our next question, guys. In which of the following states Assam Rifles has constructed a war memorial named as Veer Samriti? So the right answer here is, that is in Nagaland. So in Nagaland, Assam Rifles has constructed a war memorial and its name is Veer Samriti. Next question. In which of the following 9th edition of India-Bangladesh Joint Military Exercise Sampriti was held? So you have to tell me where this military exercise has taken place. And the right answer here is, that is Meghalaya. In Meghalaya, the 9th edition of Sampriti has taken place. So guys, two key informations. Sampriti is a military exercise and it is between India and Bangladesh. Next question. Which of the following trains will be started by Indian Railways to help farmers transport perishable goods in February 2020? And this is an initiative that is launched in our budget. Yes, most of you are giving right answer, and the right answer is, that is Kisan Rail. So Kisan Rail is the right answer. Next question. Which of the following countries has been officially, says, look at the keyword, readmitted to the Commonwealth countries in February 2020? So you have to tell me which of the following country has been readmitted. The right answer here is, guys, that is Maldives. So Maldives has been readmitted to the Commonwealth countries. So you have to tell me now, Maldives has become which, in number wise, which country Maldives has become to join the Commonwealth nations. Yes, most of you are giving right answer. Guys, the right answer is that is Maldives has become the 54th nation to join Commonwealth countries. And yes, Maldives capital is Male. Next question, guys. Who among the following has been conferred with Kalpana Chawla Excellence Award? Kalpana Chawla Excellence Award. Yes, guys, the right answer is that is Dilraj Preet Kaur. So, Miss Dilraj Preet Kaur has been conferred with Kalpana Chawla Excellence Award in February 2020. Next question. On which of the following dates Indian Coast Guard Day is observed? So, you have to tell me Indian Coast Guard Day is observed on which of the following dates? The right answer here is that is on 1st of February. On 1st of February, Indian Coast Guard Day is observed. Next question. As per the Transparency International Index, which of the following states has topped in the ranking of best practices, that is followed states in the budget formulation? Yes, guys, most of you are giving right answers. The right answer is that is Assam. So Assam has topped the Transparency International Index in the terms of best practices. Next question, guys. Which of the following companies will manufacture advanced unmanned combat aerial space vehicle, that is UCAVs, in partnership with Israel Aerospace Industries in February 2020? Yes, guys, you are familiar with all the options. And the right answer is that is Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. So it is not ISRO or not, neither it is DRDO. The right answer is that is Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following states has hosted Narmada Mahotsav in February 2020? Narmada Mahotsav. The right answer is that is state of Madhya Pradesh. If I give you a trick to memorize it, Narmada originates from Amarkantak and it lies in Madhya Pradesh. So you can, it is a static question, but you can memorize it in for your current affairs also. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following players has won the Australian Open men? Australian Open men in February 2020. So you have to tell me who has won Australian Open men in February 2020. Yes, the right answer is that is Novak Djokovic. So Novak Djokovic has won the Australian Open in men category in February 2020. And you have to tell me now Novak Djokovic is from which of the following country? He belongs to which country, Novak Djokovic? So guys, he belongs to Serbia. So he belongs to Serbia. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following Indian naval ships is providing humanitarian assistance and disaster relief at Madagascar, and the operation named is Operation Vanilla? So I have highlighted both the keywords, where the disaster relief has taken place and what is the name of it. You have to tell me the name of Indian naval ship here. Guys, right answer is that is INS Arawat. So INS Arawat is providing humanitarian assistance and disaster relief at Madagascar. That is the, and the name of this event is that is Operation Vanilla. Moving on to the next question. That recently Mr. Tushar Kanjilal has passed away, and he was a famous social activist. Mr. Tushar Kanjilal, he is a famous social activist. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following players has been elected as President of Paralympics Committee of India? So you have to tell me. I think, guys, this is the most easiest question of today's lecture. एंड शी इज़ वेरी फेमस, शी इज़ वेरी फेमस पैरालंपिक ऑफ इंडिया. येस द राइट आंसर इज दैट इज मिस दीपा मलिक. सो मिस दीपा मलिक हैज़ बीन इलेक्टेड एज द प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ पैरालंपिक्स कमेटी ऑफ इंडिया. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सिटीज इंडियन नेवी हैज लॉन्च्ड अ कोस्टल सिक्योरिटी एक्सरसाइज दैट इज माल्टा अभियान. सो इट इज अ कोस्टल सिक्योरिटी एक्सरसाइज. यू हैव टू टेल मी दैट इन विच सिटी दिस इंडियन नेवी हैज लॉन्च्ड दिस माल्टा अभियान. गाइस राइट आंसर इज दैट इज इन कोलकाता. सो इन कोलकाता दिस इवेंट हैज टेकन प्लेस. मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, रिसेंटली विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंट्रीज हैज इनॉग्रेटेड एकुशे बुक फेयर. यू टेल मी विच कंट्री हैज लॉन्च दिस एकुशे बुक फेयर. एंड यस गाइस द राइट आंसर इट इज दैट इज बांग्लादेश. सो बांग्लादेश हैज इनॉग्रेटेड दिस एकुशे बुक फेयर एंड इट इज द लार्जेस्ट बुक फेयर ऑफ बांग्लादेश. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वर्ल्ड कैंसर डे वॉज ऑब्जर्व ऑन 4th February 2020. यू हैव टू टेल मी द थीम, द थीम ऑफ द वर्ल्ड कैंसर डे दैट इज 2020 थीम ऑफ वर्ल्ड कैंसर डे. द राइट आंसर इट इज दैट इज आई एम एंड आई विल. दैट इज आई एम एंड आई विल इज द थीम ऑफ द वर्ल्ड कैंसर डे. सो ऑल दीज ऑप्शन आर रॉन्ग एंड आई एम एंड आई विल इज द राइट आंसर. मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, रिसेंटली विच ऑफ द स्टेट्स हैज बीन अवॉर्डेड फॉर बेस्ट परफॉर्मेंस अंडर प्रधानमंत्री मातृवंदना योजना दैट इज पी एम एम बी वाई. यू हैव टू टेल मी दैट विच स्टेट हैज बीन अवॉर्डेड द बेस्ट परफॉर्मेंस स्टेट. द राइट आंसर हेयर इज मध्य प्रदेश. सो मध्य प्रदेश हैज बीन अवॉर्डेड द बेस्ट परफॉर्मेंस स्टेट अंडर द प्रधानमंत्री मातृवंदना योजना. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, अकॉर्डिंग टू काउंटर पॉइंट रिसर्च रिपोर्ट दैट इज काउंटर पॉइंट रिसर्च रिपोर्ट, इंडिया हैज सरपास्ड विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंट्री टू बिकम द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट स्मार्टफोन मार्केट इन द वर्ल्ड. सो यू टेल मी, आई हैव टोल्ड यू द रिपोर्ट दैट इंडिया हैज सरपास्ड टू बिकम द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट स्मार्टफोन. यू हैव टेल मी विच कंट्री इंडिया हैज सरपास्ड. द राइट आंसर इट इज दैट इज यूएसए. सो इंडिया हैज सरपास्ड यूएसए टू बिकम द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट स्मार्टफोन मार्केट इन द वर्ल्ड. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, रिसेंटली विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंट्रीज हैज डिक्लेयर्ड नेशनल इमरजेंसी टू बैटल अगेंस्ट लोकस्टस. सो लोकस्टस इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ ग्रास होपर एंड यू हैव टू टेल मी विच कंट्री हैज डिक्लेयर्ड नेशनल इमरजेंसी. सो गाइज राइट आंसर इज पाकिस्तान. नाउ गाइज यू हैव टू टेल मी वन थिंग, अलॉन्ग विद पाकिस्तान वन मोर कंट्री हैज डिक्लेयर्ड अ नेशनल इमरजेंसी रिगार्डिंग दिस लोकस्टस. सो यू हैव टू नेम मी दैट कंट्री. द कंट्री इज सोमालिया. सो सोमालिया हैज ऑल्सो डिक्लेयर्ड एन इमरजेंसी दैट इज नेशनल इमरजेंसी टू बैटल लोकस्टस. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट्स हैज होस्टेड अंतःप्रज्ञा 2020. नाउ अंतःप्रज्ञा 2020 इज इंडियाज बिगेस्ट रूरल टेक्निकल फेस्टिवल. सो गाइज दिस क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड इन योर जीए, इट कैन बी आस्क्ड इन योर एआईडी सेक्शन बिकॉज देर इज वन कीवर्ड हियर दैट इज रूरल टेक्निकल एंड देर इन अवर सिलेबस रूरल डेवलपमेंट इज वन ऑफ द की टॉपिक्स दैट वी हैव टू कवर. सो यू हैव टू टेल मी द आंसर दैट विच स्टेट हैज होस्टेड दिस अंतःप्रज्ञा 2020. The guys, right answer is that is Telangana. Telangana has hosted this Antaprajna 2020. Next question, which of the following countries has recently appointed Muhammad Alawi as its Prime Minister? So you have to tell me which country has appointed Muhammad Alawi as its Prime Minister. So right answer is that is Iraq. Now Iraq has appointed Muhammad Alawi as its Prime Minister. They can change the question also that Iraq has recently appointed which of the following person as its Prime Minister. So then your answer will be Muhammad Alawi. Next question guys, according to the National Crime Record Bureau, which of the following states has observed highest incidence of missing children in 2019? So I have highlighted the keyword here, that is highest incidence of missing children. Guys, the right answer is that is Madhya Pradesh. So Madhya Pradesh has recorded the highest incidence of missing children in 2019 according to National Crime Record Bureau. Now next question, guys. In which of the following states Kumbh Abhishekam of Brihadeshwara temple was held in February 2020? So you have to tell me that Kumbh Abhishekam of Brihadeshwara temple was held in February 2020 in which of the following state? Guys, you can easily answer. If you have revised your static topics, you can easily answer this question. It is a very simple question based on your static knowledge. The right answer it is that is Tamil Nadu, because Brihadeshwara temple is located in Tamil Nadu. So it is not that it is a current affair question, it is a static question. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following states will host Samakka Saralamma Jatra, that is the biggest tribal fair, in February 2020? So guys, the right answer here, you tell me the right answer. The right answer here is that is the state of Telangana. State of Telangana is hosting the biggest tribal fair. We have just discussed that biggest rural technical festival has also taken place in Telangana. So you can memorize, because your exam is approaching near. So don't hosh-posh your preparation. Just be relaxed. See, list down the states that where some event has taken place. It will be easy to memorize to use. Then relate it with some of the states. Like I have related Telangana for you, that rural technical festival has taken place in Telangana. And now the biggest tribal fair has also taken place in Telangana. Now moving on to the next question. In which of the following cities 22nd edition of India International Seafood Show was held? You tell me, India International Seafood Show has taken place in which of the following cities? So guys, right answer it is that is Kochi. So in Kochi, this edition has taken the place. Next question. Who among the following has been appointed as the chairman and MD of Coal India Limited? It is very important because Coal India Limited is in news for various purposes in the previous year. So you have to tell me who is the appointed as MD and chairman of the Coal India Limited. And the right answer here is that is Mr. Pramod Agarwal. So Mr. Pramod Agarwal has been appointed as the chairman and managing director, that is MD of Coal India Limited. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following birds has been chosen as the mascot of 36th National Games to be held in Goa? So both, see, two things that you can memorize from this question is 36th National Games are going to take place in Goa. Now you tell me the bird which has been chosen as the mascot. So guys, the bird name is, that is flame-throated bulbul, and it has been named as Rubigula. So it has been named as Rubigula, but the bird is flame-throated bulbul. Next question. Who among the following has been presented with International Gandhi Award for leprosy? So leprosy is a disease, and you have to tell me that who is presented as International Gandhi Award for leprosy. And the right answer here is, that is Mr. Dr. N.S. Dharmashaktu. So Dr. N.S. Dharmashaktu has been presented with International Gandhi Award for leprosy. So next question, guys. Which of the following declarations has been adopted during the first India-Africa Defense Minister Conclave? So you have to tell me which declaration has been adopted during this India-Africa Defense Minister Conclave. So guys, the right answer is that is Lucknow Declaration. If I talk about Lucknow Declaration, you have to tell me that recently a defense expo has taken place, that is 13th defense expo has taken place in India. You have to tell me that in which city this defense expo has taken place. So guys, right answer. The right answer it is that is in Lucknow. This conclave has taken, that is Defence Expo has taken place, and under this Defence Expo, the first Indian African Defence Minister conclave has taken place. So see, the news is about Defence Expo, but within news, there is one major news, that is first Indian African Defence Minister conclave has taken place. So next question, guys, who among the following was appointed as the chairman of Second Judicial Pay Commission? So that is Second Judicial Pay Commission. You have to tell me who is appointed as the chairman. So guys, right answer is that is Dr. P.V. Reddy. So Mr. P.V. Reddy has been appointed as the chairman of Second Judicial Pay Commission. Next question. Which of the following countries has signed an MOU, that is Memorandum of Understanding, with India for research and higher education to strengthen their bilateral partnership? That is to strengthen the bilateral partnership in terms of higher education. India has signed a Memorandum of Understanding with which of the following country? And the right answer it is that is Norway. So India has signed an MOU with the Norway. Next question. International Day of Zero Tolerance Against FGM is observed on. So you have to tell me that Zero Tolerance Day against FGM. So the keyword here is FGM. If you know the full form of FGM, then it is a very easy question. If you don't know about FGM, then it is the most difficult question you can assume. So guys, right answer here is that is on 6th February. And if I talk about FGM, FGM stands for female genital mutilation. So they can ask you full form of FGM also, that what does G stands for FG, what does G stands in FGM? It is female, that is genital, and female genital mutilation. Next question. Which of the following Indian organization has handed over the artillery gun, and the gun name is Sharang, to Indian Army? You have to tell me an artillery gun Sharang has been handed over to Indian Army. So you have to tell me which Indian organization has handed over this Sharang. So guys, the right answer is that is Ordnance Factory Board. So Miss Ordnance Factory Board has handed over the artillery gun Sharang to Indian Army. They can even ask you a question that recently an artillery gun was handed over to Indian Army by Ordnance Factory Board, named it, and your answer will be Sharang. Next question. And if I talk about Sharang, it is the first 130mm M46 artillery gun that has been upgraded to 155mm. Next question. Who among the following has become the new CEO of Credit Suisse company? You have to tell me who has become the new CEO of Credit Suisse company. I know guys, appointments are hard to remember, but you have to remember them, that because these kind of questions are generally asked in your GA sections and you have to memorize them. I know it is a bit difficult, but nothing me and you can do, but the questions are asked, so you have to do it, these questions. So guys, the right answer it is that is Thomas Gottsen. So Mr. Thomas Gottsen has been appointed as CEO of Credit Suisse company. Next question. Which of the following players has been named as India's, see the keyword here is non-playing, India's non-playing Davis Cup captain? So if you are a fan of tennis, you can easily answer this question, because if I see the options, most of the persons I knew, and they have captained India in Davis Cup. So guys, the right answer here is that is Mr. Rohit Rajpal. See, an elimination method can easily be adopted here. Leander Pace, Mahesh Bhupathi, Rohan Bopanna. These are the very known faces of Indian tennis, and they all have captained India in Davis Cup. So you can get confused between Rohit Rajpal and Divij Sharan, and then you can easily answer, because you have, by elimination you have come from 5 to 2 options. The right answer is Mr. Rohit Rajpal. Next question. Which of the following countries has fined Apple over iPhone slowing software in February 2020. You have to tell me which country has been fined. So guys, right answer here is, that is France. So France has fined Apple over iPhone for slowing software in February 2020. Guys, I know I am a bit fast today, but in GA section, you have to get your answer within 5 to 10 seconds so that then you can apply your time in ESI and ART section. If you are taking 1.5 minutes in GA, it is not possible to complete your exam. It will be difficult. So I am a bit fast today, I know, but you have to be on this pace to match up in your exam, because day after tomorrow you are appearing for your exam, that you must have your speed to do these kind of questions in quick, just within 5 seconds or 10 seconds. So next question. Recently newspaper Mook Nayak has completed 100 years in February 2020. Now who among the following has started this newspaper? You have to tell me who among the following has started this newspaper. And guys, the right answer it is, that is Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar has launched a newspaper Mook Nayak, and recently it has completed 100 years. Next question. Who among the following has been appointed as CEO of IBM? Again, a CEO has come, but nothing me and you can do. You have to memorize this. I know it is a bit difficult for me, but we have to memorize it. The right answer it is, that is Arvind Krishna. So Mr. Arvind Krishna has been appointed as the CEO of IBM. Next question. Now, after Brexit, which has recently taken place in February 2020, European Union has left with how many members? Guys, this is the most talked about topic of previous 2 to 3 years. You have to tell me first of all about the how many countries has been left. The right answer is, that is 27 countries is now left with European Union. Now you have to tell me, what does Brexit stands for? Because it is the most easiest question that can be asked, but most of you can say that I don't know what is Brexit. So Brexit is simply a term that was given when Britain has decided to exit European Union. Now, if I talk about European Union, you have to tell me that European Union's headquarter is in which of the following place? So tell me, where is the headquarter of European Union? The headquarter is in Brussels. So it is in Brussels headquarter. Next question. Recently, which of the following countries has announced to count LGBT population for the first time? See, the keyword here is first time. LGBT population has been counted by a country in its census. You have to name that country. The right answer it is, that is Nepal. So recently Nepal has announced that it will count LGBT community in its next census. So guys, there is one question here, seeing this word census. Recently, US has allowed one minority to be counted in its census of 2020. We have to name that minority community. The right answer here is, that is Sikh community. So, Sikh community will be included for the first time in US census as independent minority. So this is also important because it is also taking place for the first time. Next question. Which of the following countries has claimed to kill Qasim al-Rimi in Yemen? You have to tell me which country has claimed this. And the right answer is USA. USA has claimed to kill Qasim al-Rimi in Yemen. So USA has claimed lots of persons. Recently, USA has killed one person of Iran. It is very famous Iran commander. You have to name that person in the comment box, that recently USA has claimed that he has killed Iran's commander in chief. You have to name that person. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following organization has signed an MOU with Elbit System for the promotion and marketing of digital head-up displays, that is HUDs for fighter planes? So again a question on defense, guys, you have to tell me. The right answer is, that is HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. So recently Hindustan Aeronautics Limited has signed an MOU with Elbit System for the promotion and marketing of digital head-up displays, HUDs. If I talk about Elbit System, Elbit System is an Israel-based defense electronics company. Okay, next question. Who among the following has been appointed as the CEO of GoAir? The right answer is, that is Mr. Vinay Dubey. So Mr. Vinay Dubey has been appointed as CEO of GoAir. Next question, guys. Which of the following cities has hosted Kala Ghoda Art Festival? You have to tell me. And guys, these kind of questions are very much important. Something that has taken place related to art culture. The questions are generally asked in the exam. The right answer is, that is Mumbai. So Mumbai has hosted the Kala Ghoda Art Festival. Next question. Recently, which of the following metro services has become the India's second largest metro network after Delhi Metro? You have to tell me that second largest metro network after Delhi. Right answer is, that is Hyderabad. So Hyderabad has become the second largest metro network after Delhi Metro. Next question. Which of the following players has been recently chosen as the first woman to ever start Olympic torch rally? So guys, anything which is taking place for the first time is very much important in your exam, because NABARD is very much, they are very much familiar, they are very much attractive to these kind of news that has taken place for the first time. And the right answer is, that is Anna Korakaki. So Anna Korakaki has been recently chosen as the first woman to ever start an Olympic torch relay. See, most of you are, if I talk about Karolina Wozniacki, she is also in news. You have to tell me why she is in news, Karolina Wozniacki. Yes. Karolina Wozniacki is a tennis player and she has recently retired. So she is in news. Karolina Wozniacki. She has recently retired from tennis. So they can ask you from which sports she is belonging. She is belonging to tennis. Next question. What was the theme of the Financial Literacy Week? You have to tell me the theme of Financial Literacy Week. And guys, it is now your real test. Because if you see these options, nothing has been talked about literacy. So now you have to tell me what is the theme. And the theme here is, that is MSME. That is micro, small and medium enterprises. This is the theme of our Financial Literacy Week. Next question. In which of the following cities, India Solar and E-Vehicle Expo? It is India Solar and E-Vehicle Expo for MSMEs has taken place. The right answer here is, guys, that is Lucknow. So recently India Solar and E-Vehicle Expo has taken place in Lucknow. I have already discussed with you, Defense Expo has taken place in Lucknow. Now E-Vehicle Expo. Vehicle, defense, both expo has taken place in Lucknow. So you can see what I am trying to say is, memorize this, because day after tomorrow we are appearing for exam. This is the best strategy that you can apply now, that quickly revise your things and just make a mnemonic in thing that yes, whenever you heard about Lucknow, yes, Defence Expo has taken place, Vehicle Expo has taken place. I memorize about Telangana, Rural Agri-Tech Fest has taken place. Okay, Tribal Festival has taken place. This is the best thing that you can do now. Next question. The government has set a target of installation of how much solar power and how much wind power capacity in the country by December 2022, that is 2022. This is also an easy question if you have revised your static and if you are familiar to your news. It is also one of the easiest question. If I see the right answer is that is 100 gigawatt and 60 gigawatt, because these are mentioned our INDC, that is intended nationally determined contributions that India has signed under the Paris Climate Change. Now India has set up the target of 100 gigawatt of producing, so India has set up a target of producing 175 gigawatt of solar, 175 gigawatt of renewable energy, and out of which 100 gigawatt will be from solar and 60 gigawatt will be from wind energy. Next question. Who among the following has become youngest girl in the world to summit Mount Aconcagua? You have to tell me, and their answer is that is Kamya Karthikeyan. So Miss Kamya Karthikeyan has become the youngest girl in the world to summit Mount Aconcagua. It is Aconcagua. Next question. Giriraj Kishore has passed away recently and he was a renowned. So see, these kind of questions are generally asked and tough to remember, but have to remember this. The right answer is that is he is a novelist. So Mr. Giriraj Kishore is a famous novelist and he has recently passed away. Next question. On which of the following dates World Pulses Day is observed? Very important question, can be asked in your phase 1 as well as your phase 2, important for your AID section also. And right answer here is that is on 10th February. On 10th February every year World Pulse Day is observed, and it has been initiated. So the day has been initiated from which year? Tell me that from which year this day has been initiated, World Pulse Day. Yes, the World Pulse Day is initiated from 2019. Yes, from 2019 this World Pulse Day has been initiated. And recently World Pulse Day conclave or World Pulse Day meeting has taken place in New Delhi. So New Delhi, the World Pulse Day conference has taken place. Next question. Which of the following movie has won the Best Picture Award at Oscars in February 2020? So most of you must be familiar with this award, that is Oscar. Now you have to tell me which movie has won the Best Picture Award. And the right answer here is that is Parasite. So the movie Parasite has won the Best Picture Award at the Oscars this year. Next question. Which of the following countries has announced that it will send laser torting robot, that is laser torting robot, in its mission to Mars? You have to tell me which country. Guys, the right answer is that is USA. So USA has planned and announced that it will send a laser torting robot in its mission to Mars. Recently ISRO has also formed a humanoid robot that they are saying that they will send it they will use it in Operation Gaganyaan. You have to tell me the name of that humanoid robot. Yes, I am looking for your answers. And the right answer is that is Vayumitra. Yes. those of you who have said Vayomitra, they are absolutely right. Moving on to the next question, guys. In February 2020, which of the following countries has approved the sale of a $1.867 billion integrated air defense weapon system to India? You have to tell me, guys. Be fast. The right answer here is, that is USA. So recently, USA has approved the sale of a IADWS to India. Next question: what is the official name of new coronavirus that has been given by WHO? So you know that coronavirus has occurred in China. You have to tell me that what is the name given by WHO to this virus. The right answer here is, that is COVID-19. So COVID-19 is the official name given to coronavirus. Guys, if I talk about coronavirus, now you have to tell me that where is the first case of coronavirus reported in India. Very important question. That where is the first case of coronavirus reported in India? The place is Thrissur and the state is Kerala. So Kerala has declared a state emergency on coronavirus also, and the place is Thrissur. And if I talk about Thrissur, it has become the first digital district in Kerala. So see, one thing important now. Now moving on to the next question, guys. World Radio Day was observed on February 13th. Now you have to tell me, what is the theme of the World Radio Day? The theme here is, guys, that is radio and diversity. So this is the theme of the World Radio Day, and themes are also very much important for our exam. Next question: which of the following countries has won the ICC Under 19 Cricket World Cup in February 2020? The cricket lovers, one of the easiest question for you. I give you a hint because it is our neighboring country. Yes, and the right answer here is, that is Bangladesh. So recently Bangladesh has defeated India to win its first maiden. Yes, they have won the Under 19 World Cup for the first time. Guys, again, a World Cup, that is Women's T20 World Cup, is taking place. Now you have to tell me that in which country this Women's T20 World Cup is taking place. Yes, the right answer is, that is in Australia. So in Australia, Women's T20 World Cup is taking place. And see, Men's T20 World Cup will also take place in Australia. Now moving to the next question: who among the following has become the youngest cricketer to score a half century in international cricket? You have to tell me the youngest cricketer. The right answer is, that is Kushal Mala. So Kushal Mala has become the youngest cricketer to score a half century in international cricket. Next question: in which of the following cities 33rd African Union Summit, that is African Union Summit, has taken place? Guys, the right answer is, that is Addis Ababa. So in Addis Ababa, 33rd African Union Summit has taken place. Moving on to the next question: which of the following cities has hosted 13th Conference of Parties of the Convention on Migratory Species of Wild Animals, that is CMS? So guys, India is hosting this conference for the first time. You have to tell me that in which city this CMS has taken place. The right answer here is, that is Gandhinagar. In Gandhinagar, as you have to tell me the name of the mascot. name of the mascot of this conference? Yeah, the name of the mascot is, that is Gibby. And if I talk about the logo is based on, yes, guys, the logo is based on, it is based on a traditional art from South India, that is Kolam. So remember the theme is migratory species connect the planet and we welcome them home. Easy to memorize that, because it is a initiative of migratory species, so easy to memorize the theme. Logo is inspired from Kolam and mascot is Gibby. They can ask you, like I have asked you about the bird for the who was mascot for the 36th national games, and now they can ask Gibby is, so Gibby is a Indian bustard, that is great Indian bustard. Next question, who among the following has won the national snooker championship? I see national snooker championship. Who among the following has won the national snooker championship? The right answer is, that is Aditya Mehta. So Aditya Mehta has won the national snooker championship. Next question, recently which of the following organization has started developing a 200 kilometer strike range tactical ballistic missile? The name of the missile is Pranash. Bug up, guys, bug up. And because exam is approaching near, it is the best thing that you are revising all your February current affairs now. And right answer is, that is DRDO. So DRDO has started developing a ballistic missile, that is Pranash. Next question, which of the following state government has set up a FPO, that is farmer producer organization, to boost agricultural produce? The right answer is, that is Goa. So Goa has set up a FPO to boost agricultural produce. Next question, recently which of the following institute has released the Future of Earth 2020 report? Report Future of Earth has been released. Now you have to tell me which of the following has released this report. Right answer is, that is IISc Bangalore. So Indian Institute of Science Bangalore has released the Future of the Earth 2020 report. Now next question, with which of the following countries Indian Armed Force has started its joint exercise Ajay Warrior? So keyword is Ajay Warrior. You tell me with which country it has taken place. Easy question, I say. The right answer is, that is UK, United Kingdom. Guys, earlier I have discussed about Sampirti. It was between India and Bangladesh. Now, Ajay Warrior, it is between India and UK. Next question. Recently, President Ramnath Kovind has awarded the President's Colour, the President Colour Award, to which of the following Naval Training Institute? See, the keyword is Naval Training Institute. The right answer is, that is INS Shivaji. So INS Shivaji has been awarded the President Colour by President Mr. Ramnath Kovind. Next question, who among the following will be the chairperson of Group on Defense and Internal Security? See, Group on Defense and Internal Security constituted by 15th Finance Commission. You have to tell me the chairperson. Guys, if you see this option, I think this is the most easiest question in terms of option. You can easily, by elimination method, you can easily eliminate all the options. And the right answer is Mr. N.K. Singh. See this keyword, Finance Commission. He is head of Finance Commission, Mr. N.K. Singh. You can easily guess it from this thing also. Next question. Who among the following has been declared as world's oldest living man? Guys, recently it has been declared world's oldest man. So the world's oldest man is, that is Chitetsu Watanabe. I don't know whether my pronunciation is right or wrong, but and he is from Japan. So guys, see, this is one of the easiest thing to remember. Whenever you see, if they ask about which country the person belongs to, who is the world's oldest man, it is Japan. So it is now, they used to live longer than I think everyone in the world. So let's move to the next question. Who among the following has been appointed as UK's finance minister? So recently election has taken place in UK, and Mr. Boris Johnson has won. So you have to tell me, who is UK's finance minister now? He is Indian, somehow related to India, and it is Mr. Rishi Sunak. So Mr. Rishi Sunak has been appointed as UK's finance minister. Now next question. Who among the following has been appointed as director of cricket of UAE? That is director of cricket of UAE. And the answer here is, that is Mr. Robin Singh. So Indian cricketer Robin Singh has been appointed as director of cricket of UAE. Next question, guys. Who among the following has won player of the year 2019 title by International Hockey Federation? So International Hockey Federation has given the title, that is player of the year 2019. Hockey lovers, they can easily give this answer because they are familiar with this name, very easy. And the name is, that is Manpreet Singh. The Indian hockey team's captain, Manpreet Singh, has won the Player of the Year 2019 award from International Hockey Federation. Next question. Who among the following has been appointed as Chairman and Managing Director of Air India? Guys, keyword here is Air India. Yes, you have to tell me the Chairman and MD of Air India. The right answer here is, that is Rajiv Bansal. So Mr. Rajiv Bansal has been appointed as the Chairman and Managing Director of Air India. Next question, guys. Which of the following trains has connected three major Jyotirlings that are located in Varanasi, Ujjain and Omkaleshwar? You have to tell me the name of the train. So recently, I think our Prime Minister, Mr. Modi, has launched this train. Most of you are giving the right answer. Yes, it is Kashi Mahakal Express. So Kashi Mahakal Express is a train which will be connecting three major Jyotirlings, that are Varanasi, Ujjain and Omkareshwar. Guys, you have to tell me, Omkareshwar is located near which river? Near which river Omkareshwar is located? See, I have discussed about this river in this lecture. That is why I am asking you this question. Yes, right answer is, that is Narmada. Near Narmada, Omkareshwar is situated. And if I talk about Ujjain, Ujjain is located on river Shipra. Now moving on to the next question, guys. See, as per the data released by Ministry of Environment, which of the following states had the highest number of human casualties? See, keyword here is human casualties due to human elephant conflict. answer here is, guys, that is West Bengal. So West Bengal has, according to data by Ministry of Environment, West Bengal has the highest number of human elephant conflicts. So you can easily get confused by this option, that is Karnataka, but it is not Karnataka, it is West Bengal. Next question, which of the following states has launched Pyar Ka Pauda? A Pyar Ka Pauda campaign has been launched by which of the following state? The right answer it is, that is Bihar. So Bihar has launched a campaign, that is Pyar Ka Pauda, and the campaign is launched to promote practice of planting trees in the state. Next question, recently which of the following states has observed the festival, that is Lui Ngaini? Lui Ngaini is a state festival. You have to tell me in which state it has been observed. The right answer is, guys, that is Manipur. In Manipur, this Lui Ngaini festival has been observed. And if I talk about this festival, it is a seed sowing festival. Next question. Recently, Padam Shri awardee Mr. Wendell Rodrigues has passed away. Now you tell me, he is associated to which of the following? Question on obituaries are asked in the phase 1 exam, and they generally ask these kind of questions, that to which event or which of the following the person belongs. The answer here is, that is fashion designer. So he is a famous fashion designer, Mr. Wendell Rodrigues. Next question, which of the following coaches has been named among the recipients of the 2019 International Olympic Committee's Coaches Lifetime, that is Coaches Lifetime Achievement Award? Tell me, you have to tell me the name of the coach who has been given this award, that is Coaches Lifetime Achievement Award. And guys, the right answer here is, that is Mr. Pulela Gopichand, famous badminton player as well as famous badminton coach nowadays. That is Mr. Pulela Gopichand has been awarded Coaches Lifetime Achievement Award. Next question, who among the following has been appointed as the chairman and managing director of GAIL, Gas Authority of India Limited? Guys, see these options, you can easily eliminate two options because we have just discussed these options. The right answer is Mr. Manoj Jain. Rajiv Bansal can be eliminated, Arvind Krishna can be eliminated. So right answer is, that is Mr. Manoj Jain. Next question, according to the National Health Mission, which of the following states has reported highest percentage of newborn deaths? That is, highest percentage of newborn deaths has been reported by which of the following state in the past 3 years? The right answer is, guys, that is Madhya Pradesh. In state of Madhya Pradesh, it has reported that there is highest percentage of newborn deaths in the past 3 years. So moving on to the next question, which of the following banks has recently signed an MOU with Odisha government, that is Odisha government, to provide smart banking solutions to startups? You have to tell me which of the following bank. And guys, the right answer is, that is HDFC Bank. HDFC Bank has recently signed an MOU with Odisha government to provide smart banking solutions to startups. So next question, at which of the following places CRPF has inaugurated a memorial on the first anniversary of Pulwama attacks? So Pulwama attacks, that is a terrorist attack, has taken place last year. So CRPF has inaugurated a memorial for their first anniversary. You have to tell me where it has been inaugurated. The right answer is, guys, that is in Srinagar. And if they talk about the camp name is Lethpura. Lethpura camp. Next question. Which of the following Indian players has won the Laureus Sporting Movement Award? Laureus Sporting Movement Award is won by which of the following Indian player? All of them are cricketers. Again, the right answer is that is Sachin Tendulkar, God of Indian cricket or God of cricket, has won this award, that is Laureus Sporting Movement Award. Now moving on to the next question, guys. Recently, government has unveiled a program that is Sutrapik. Sutrapik for the research on which of the following indigenous cattle? Very important for your AID section. Very important question for your AID section. You have to tell me that Sutrapik has been a program to unveil which of the following indigenous cattle. And the right answer is that is cow. For cow, this program has been unveiled. Next question. Who among the following will head the panel that has been set up by the Archaeological Survey of India to locate the grave of Mughal Prince Dara Shikoh? So, Mughal Prince Dara Shikoh, who is the elder brother of Aurangzeb and elder son of Shah Jahan. So, recently, Archaeological Survey of India has decided that it has created a panel to locate the grave of Mughal Prince Dara Shikoh. You have to tell me the person's name who will head this panel. Guys, the right answer is that is TJ Alone. So, TJ Alone will be heading the panel which has been set up by ASI, that is Archaeological Survey of India, to locate the grave of Mughal Prince Dara Shikoh. Now, next question. Which of the following states has issued an advisory about yellow rust disease in wheat crops? So, easily you can memorize two things from the question, that there is a disease named as yellow rust disease and it is usually taking place in wheat crops. So, you have to tell me which state. The right answer is that is Punjab. So, Punjab has issued an advisory about yellow rust disease in wheat crops. Next question. Which of the following states has launched Yodhavu? Yodhavu, that is a mobile application to combat drug menace. Yodhavu. The right answer is that is Kerala. So, Kerala has launched this Yodhavu mobile application to combat drug menace. Next question. Who among the following has been appointed as finance secretary? Very important question. So tell me who in the following has been appointed as finance secretary. The right answer is that is Debashish Panda. So Mr. Debashish Panda has been appointed as the new finance secretary. Next question. Who among the following has launched Children's Protection Fund for India in February 2020? The right answer is that is Prince Charles. So, Britain Prince, that is Mr. Prince Charles, has launched a Children's Protection Fund for India. Next question. Which of the following companies will acquire Bhushan Power and Steel Limited after the approval from NCLAT, that is National Company Law Appellate Tribunal? You have to tell me the name of the company which will acquire this company. The right answer is that is JSW Steels. So JSW Steels will acquire this Bhushan Power and Steel Limited. Next question. In which of the following states Kambala Race has taken place? Nowadays, Kambala Race is very popular because of Indian Usain Bolt. Now, you have to tell me that where this Kambala Race has taken place. Guys, answer fast that where this Kambala Race has taken place It has taken place in, that is, in Karnataka. And if I ask you about the name of that person who is known as now as Indian Usain Bolt. Indian Usain Bolt. And yes, its name is Srinivas Gowda. So Mr. Srinivas Gowda is now being named as Indian Usain Bolt. Next question. World Day of Social Justice is observed every year on. So World Day of Social Justice is observed on. Yes guys, it is observed on 20th February. So on 20th February, World Day of Social Justice is observed. Next question. Which of the following states is set to become North India's first bird ringing station? That is first bird ringing station for observation, monitoring and research on migratory birds. The answer here is, that is Bihar. So Bihar will be, it has become the first state to launch first bird ringing station in North India. Next question. In which of the following states, world's largest known subterranean fish has been recently discovered? Answer quickly guys. The right answer is, that is in Meghalaya. So in Meghalaya, world's largest known subterranean fish has been discovered. Next question. Ministry of HRD, that is Human Resource Development, has celebrated Matri Bhasha Divas, that is Matra Bhasha Divas, on 21st February. Now you tell me the theme of this Matra Bhasha Divas. The right answer is, guys, that is celebrating our multilingual heritage. That is celebrating our multilingual heritage, Matra Bhasha Divas theme. Next question. As per the Ormex Media's Indian box office report, which of the following film industries has become biggest gainer in India in the year 2019? You have to tell me which of the following film industries has become biggest gainer. The right answer here is, that is Hollywood industry. So Hollywood industry has become the biggest gainer in India in the year 2019. Next question. The Soil Health Card Day is observed on. Important question. Soil Health Card Day. So guys, it is observed on 19th February. So this is all about your GA in news. So you can take break of 5 to 10 seconds. Then we will be starting with reports and indices. So guys, let's start with this reports and indices. First question about the reports. Now, which of the following has published the research report, that is EcoRap? You have to tell me which of the following has published this research report, that is EcoRap. And guys, the right answer is, that is State Bank of India. So State Bank of India has published a research report known as EcoRap. Next question. Emission gap report has been published by, important question, emission gap report. And guys, it has been published by UNEP, that is United Nations Environment Program. It has published the emission gap report 2019. If I talk about this report, it has reported that countries should reduce greenhouse gas emission target to what percent every year between 2020 to 2030 to meet the target of Paris Agreement. You tell me the greenhouse gas emission target. And the answer here is, that is 7.6%. It said that emission of 7.6% every year has to be done between 2020 to 2030 to meet the target of Paris Agreement. Next question. एज पर द एमिशन गैप रिपोर्ट द अर्थ्स टेम्परेचर मे राइज टू अप टू व्हाट परसेंट बाय 2100। द आंसर इज दैट इज 3.2 डिग्री सेल्सियस। सो अप टू 3.2 डिग्री सेल्सियस द रिपोर्ट सेज द टेम्परेचर मे राइज बाय 2100। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग हैज रिलीज्ड द ग्लोबल डिप्लोमेसी इंडेक्स। इंपॉर्टेंट रिपोर्ट, ग्लोबल डिप्लोमेसी इंडेक्स हैज बीन रिलीज्ड। सो गाइस, द आंसर इट इज दैट इज लोई इंस्टीट्यूट, LOWY, लोई इंस्टीट्यूट। इट हैज रिलीज्ड द ग्लोबल डिप्लोमेसी इंडेक्स 2019। एंड नाउ एज पर दिस इंडेक्स, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंट्रीज हैज द लार्जेस्ट नंबर ऑफ डिप्लोमेटिक पोस्ट अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। लार्जेस्ट नंबर ऑफ डिप्लोमेटिक पोस्ट अराउंड द वर्ल्ड, कैन यू टेल मी? द आंसर इज दैट इज चाइना। सो चाइना हैज द लार्जेस्ट नंबर ऑफ डिप्लोमेटिक पोस्ट अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। एंड इफ आई टॉक अबाउट इंडिया, कैन यू टेल मी द रैंक ऑफ इंडिया इन ग्लोबल डिप्लोमेसी इंडेक्स? The answer here is that is 12th. So India has been ranked at the 12th position in this global diplomacy index. Next question. Now, which of the following has released this crimes against children in India report? A crimes against children in India report has been released. You have to tell me which of the following has released this report. Right answer it is that is Child Relief and You. A Child Relief and You organization has released this report, that is Crimes Against Children in India. Next question guys, as per the report on crimes against children in India, what is the crimes against children rose by, that is the crimes against children has rose up, has risen up by what percent? The answer it is that is 20%. So 20% is the right answer. Next question, as per the report on crimes against children in India, which of the following states, now it is asking about the states which had the highest increase in crimes against children. So guys, the right answer here is that is Jharkhand. So Jharkhand has seen the highest increase in crimes against children. Next question guys, as per the report, crime, that is crimes against children report, which of the following states has seen a decline? Earlier we have discussed which has seen the maximum increase, now we are discussing which has seen the maximum decline. Answer here is that is Manipur. So Manipur has seen the significant decline in the crimes against children. Now moving on to the next question. Guys, as per this report, that is crimes against children in India, child labor in India, important is child labor. Now what you have to tell me, what child labor in India has increased by? The answer here is that is 126%. See, by 126% the child labor has increased in India. See, now next question, which of the following has released the food vulnerability index 2019, that is food vulnerability index, which of the following has released this food vulnerability index? Guys, these indices are very important because we tried to cover all those indices which are in news in the past few months. In the past 6 months, we have tried to cover all these important indices. We tried to cover all the questions that can be asked from that report. You have to tell me who has released this index. And the answer here is that is Nomura Global Market Research has released this Food Vulnerability Index 2019. If I talk about this index, you have to tell me the rank of India in this food vulnerability index. The right answer here is guys, that is 44th. India is ranked at the 44th place. So इट रैंक्ड 50 कंट्रीज एंड इंडिया इज रैंक्ड एट 44th प्लेस. नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. एज पर द प्रॉस्पेरिटी एंड इंक्लूजन सिटी सील एंड अवार्ड्स दैट इज पिक्सा इंडेक्स, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सिटीज हैज टॉप्ड दिस इंडेक्स. PIXA index has been released recently. You have to tell me which of the following cities has topped this index. The right answer here is, guys, that is Zurich. So Zurich has topped this PIXA index. And if I talk about our Indian cities, you have to tell me which of the following Indian cities has topped this index. In PIXA index, which of the following Indian city has topped this index? The right answer here is, that is Bengaluru. Bengaluru has been ranked top among the Indian cities, but it has been ranked 83rd overall. And if I talk about other cities in India, Delhi is ranked at 101st place and Mumbai is ranked at 107th place. Moving on to the next question, guys. Which of the following has released this HDI 2019, that is Human Development Index? Most easiest question among the indices that we have covered just now. The right answer is, that is UNDP. So UNDP has released this Human Development Index 2019. You have to tell me what is India's rank in HDI. So India has shown an improvement in its ranking from the previous year. You have to tell me at which play, what is the rank of India in this year's index. So India's rank is, guys, it is 129th. India has improved its ranking. In 2018, India was placed at 130th place. Now India has moved one place further, that is in 129th place. You have to tell me now which of the following country has topped this index, that is Human Development Index. Which of the following country has topped this index? The right answer is, guys, that is Norway. So Norway has topped this Human Development Index 2019. Now next question is, which country is ranked at the last place in this HDI index? At the last place, so topped by Norway, India is at 129th place. Now you tell me which is at the last place. The country's name is Niger. It is Niger. So Niger is in the last place. Guys, there is one thing important about Niger in this news is, because recently our external affairs minister, that is Mr. S. Jaishankar, has paid visit to the West African countries for the first time. One of them was Niger. You have to tell me what is the another country which he has visited in his West African tour. You have to tell me one country I have told you, that is Niger. You have to tell me the other country which was in news, where he has visited, Mr. S. Jaishankar has visited. The right answer is, that is Tunisia. So for the first time, our external affair minister has visited on the West African side, that is western side of African continent, and he has visited two countries, that is Niger and the second is Tunisia. Now moving on to the next question, guys. Which of the following organization has released a report, that is Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Report? You have to tell me which of the following organization has released this report. The right answer is, that is both 1 and 2. Both WHO and UNICEF has jointly released this Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Report 2019. Next question. As per this report, what is the rank of India among the number of children who are not vaccinated against this measles, with 2.3 million cases in 2018. You have to tell me. The answer here is, guys, that is India is placed at the second place. So India has been ranked second highest number of children who are not vaccinated against this measles disease with 2.3 million cases. So they can ask you about the cases also. Remember this thing also, that is 2.3 million. Next question. Now, which of the following country has the highest number of, now tell me, highest number of children who are not vaccinated against measles? India is ranked at second place, but now we are focusing on highest number of children, highest number of cases. The answer here is, that is Nigeria. So Nigeria has reported the highest number of highest number of children who are not vaccinated against this measles. Next question, guys. Which of the following has released this Global Climate Risk Index 2020? It's Global Climate Risk Index, and right answer is, that is, guys, German Watch. So German Watch has released this Global Climate Risk Index 2020. Now you have to tell me rank of India, that India is ranked at what place in terms of most vulnerable country to climate change. The right answer is, guys, that is fifth place. India is ranked as the fifth most vulnerable country to climate change. And most vulnerable country due to climate change. Now you have to tell me the most vulnerable country. The right answer is, that is Japan. So according to this index, Japan has been ranked as the most vulnerable country due to climate change. Now moving on to the next question, guys. Recently TomTom has released the TomTom Traffic Index 2019. You have to tell me that which of the following cities is emerged as the worst traffic congested city in the world. Worst traffic congested city in the world. So if anybody is thinking New Delhi is not an option. So it is not New Delhi now. The right answer is, that is Bengaluru. So according to this index, Bengaluru has the worst traffic congested cities in the, Bengaluru is the worst traffic congested city in the world. Now moving on to the next question. According to UNESCO's Atlas of the World's Language in Danger Report 2019, which of the following country has the highest number of living indigenous languages in the world? You have to tell me which country has the highest number of living indigenous languages in the world. And the right answer is, that is Papua New Guinea. So Papua New Guinea has the highest number of living indigenous languages in the world. Moving on to the next question, guys. Which of the following has released the Global Gender Gap Report 2020? Global Gender Gap Report 2020. It is released by WEF, that is World Economic Forum, has released the Global Gender Gap Report 2020. Now, if I, next question. According to a report published by US National Science Foundation, which of the following is India's current rank in publishing science and engineering articles? So government is promoting this initiative, that you have to tell me what is India's rank. The right answer is, that is India has been ranked at the third place in terms of publishing science and engineering articles. India has been ranked at the third place. So moving on to the next question, guys. As per the report published by Nielsen, what percentage of Indian women fear irrelevant comments and being trolled as they access the internet? Tell me the percentage of Indian women who fear of irrelevant comments and being trolled as they access the internet. The right answer here is, guys, that is 40%. See, 40% of Indian women fear of irrelevant comments and being trolled as they access the internet. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following state has topped the Digital State of India Index 2019? That is Digital State of India Index 2019. Which of the following state has topped this index? The right answer here is, that is Chhattisgarh. So Chhattisgarh has topped the Digital States of India Index 2019. Next question. As per the report of ICRA, infrastructure credit has witnessed what percentage of growth in financial year 19, that is 2019, to rupees 21.1 trillion. They have mentioned you the amount. You have to tell me in terms of percentage that growth has taken place. The right answer here is, guys, that is 19%. So 19% growth has been witnessed in the infrastructure credit. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following bodies has released a report that is titled Market Study on E-commerce in India? So a report has been released, that is Market Study on E-commerce in India. You have to tell me which of the following has released this report. The right answer is, that is CCI. So Competition Commission of India has released this report, which is titled as Market Study on E-commerce in India. Next question. Which of the following organization has released the Global Study on Homicide 2019 report? So Global Study on Homicide 2019 report, you have to tell me, is released by The answer here is, guys, that is UNODC. So UNODC stands for United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime. They can ask your full form of UNODC also, that is United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime. Moving on to the next question, guys. What is India's rank in Global Innovation Index? So tell me India's rank in Global Innovation Index. The right answer is, guys, that is 52nd. So India is ranked at 52nd position in the Global Innovation Index 2019. Next question. Which of the following countries has topped the Global Innovation Index 2019? We have talked about India's rank. Now we are asking you, who has topped this index? So the index has been topped by Switzerland. So index has been topped by Switzerland. Next question. Which of the following has released B2C e-commerce index 2019? B2C is business to consumer e-commerce index 2019. The next question is, guys, that is UNCTAD. So UNCTAD has released this report, that is Business to Consumer E-commerce Index 2019. Next question, guys. What is India's rank in B2C? Now you have to tell me India's rank in this report, that is we have discussed the index. So India is placed at the 73rd position. So India is placed at 73rd position in this B2C e-commerce index 2019. Next question, guys. So recently the third edition of Transparency in Budget Process Report has been conducted by Transparency International India. The report has been released. Now you have to tell me that as per this index, which of the following state has topped the index? So I have told you about the edition. who has released the report. Now you have to tell me that who has topped the index. The index has been topped by, that is Assam. So Assam has topped this index. Next question, guys. As per the report that is titled as Levels and Trends in Child Mortality, which of the following states has the highest number of newborn deaths? Highest number of newborn deaths in India. You have to tell me. The right answer is, guys, the right answer is, that is Uttar Pradesh. So Uttar Pradesh has the highest number of newborn deaths in India. Next question. As per the report, that is Levels and Trends in Child Mortality, which of the following state has witnessed highest number of under 5 mortality? Earlier we have discussed highest number of death. Now we are discussing highest number of under 5 mortality rate in India. The right answer is, guys, the answer here is, that is Madhya Pradesh. So Madhya Pradesh has witnessed the highest under 5 mortality rates in India. Next question. As per these levels and trends in child mortality report, which of the following state has witnessed lowest under 5 mortality rate? We have discussed about highest under 5 mortality, that is Madhya Pradesh. You have to tell me now lowest. Now the lowest here is, that is Kerala. So Kerala has the lowest under 5 mortality rate in India. Next question. Now which of the following has released International IP Index? The International IP Index 2020 has been released. You have to tell me which of the following body has released this index. The answer here is, that is Global Innovation Policy Center, that is GIPC. So GIPC has released this International IP Index 2020. Next question, guys. As per this International IP Index, which of the following country has topped the index? So which of the following country has topped this index? You have to tell me. The right answer is, guys, that is USA. So USA has topped the index, that is International IP Index 2020. Now to tell me India's rank in this index, in this International IP Index. Guys, these are very important indices for your exams. And see, there are just few questions that are left for today's lecture. So I want you to participate more and give as much answer, because it is best thing that you are getting revision of all the February current affairs. You are now revising your reports and indices. You will be revising the Niti Aayog report. So I think this is the best thing that you can do in this moment. Revise this sheet and go through this lecture as many times as you can. The answer here is, that is 40th. So India has been ranked at the 40th place in this International IP Index 2020. Next question, guys. Now, which of the following ministry has recently launched Ease of Living Index and Municipal Performance Index 2019? You have to tell me about the ministry who will be launching this initiative. So the answer here is, that is Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So short form can be Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has released this report, that is Ease of Living Index and Municipal Performance Index 2019. Next question. So recently an International Institute for Strategic Studies has released that the report named is, that is Military Balance. You have to tell me, as per this report, what percentage of global spending on defense has increased? So it is talking about defense expenditure. You have to tell me what percentage of global spending on defense has increased. The right answer is, that is 4%. So it is saying that 4% of the global spending has increased on the defense purchase. Now, as per this report, What is India's rank in terms of defense spending in the world? So India is also spending nowadays on majorly on defense sector. You have to tell me what is India spending in terms of this military balance annual report. The answer here is, guys, that is India is placed at fifth position. So India has been ranked at the fifth position. Next question, guys. As per the survey conducted by World Breastfeeding Trends Initiative 2020, which of the following country has ranked first in supporting breastfeeding women? So tell me the first country which has been ranked at the first position. The answer here is, guys, that is Sri Lanka. So Sri Lanka has been ranked as the first or best in supporting breastfeeding women according to the World Breastfeeding Trends Initiative 2020. Next question, guys. As per this report that we have discussed, what is India's rank in supporting the breastfeeding women? See, you can see that India is ranked very way behind the other countries. Tell me rank of India. Guys, India is ranked at the 78th position. So India is ranked at 78th position in this World Breastfeeding Trends Initiative 2020. Now moving on to the next question, guys. Which of the following has released the report titled Nature Risk Ringing? Nature Risk Ringing, you have to tell me which of the following has released this report. The answer here is, guys, that is World Economic Forum. So World Economic Forum has released this report, and it has released the report in collaboration with, that is, PwC. Next question, guys. I think the question has been repeated. We have discussed it. So guys, this was all about your reports and indices. Now we have left with the Niti Aayog annual report. There are just few questions about this report that we thought that are important for your phase 1 exam. Let's discuss these questions now one by one. First question. Now, Niti Aayog has signed a memorandum of understanding with which of the following organizations for implementing the MAFPA, that is monitoring and analyzing food and agricultural policies program in India. You have to tell me. The right answer here is, guys, that is FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization. Niti Aayog has signed a memorandum of understanding, and the memorandum of understanding has been signed for implementing this monitoring and analyzing food and agricultural policies. So we have mentioned about MAFPA. It seeks to establish sustainable system to monitor, analyze and reform foods and agricultural policies to make them more effective, efficient and inclusive. Now moving on to the next question, guys. As per the Niti Aayog's annual report 2019-20, in which of the following places startups for smart agricultural conclave was held? That is, startups for smart agricultural conclave has taken place in which of the following places? The answer here is, guys, that is in Mohali. In Mohali, this startup for smart agricultural conclave has taken place. Next question, guys. Now, which of the following has released a report on assessing mitigation impact of transport sector decarbonization? The right answer is, guys, that is Niti Aayog. So Niti Aayog has released a report that is assessing mitigation impact on transport sector decarbonization. Now moving on to the next question, guys. In November 2019, Niti Aayog has launched preparation of Export Preparedness Index to rank all states and union territories on their export readiness and performance. You have to tell me which of the following is See here, the keyword is not one of the indicator of the index. The answer here is that is none of the above, because these all are the indicators and the question is asking the not. That is, which of the following is not one of the indicator. So all these are the indicators, that is bringing favorable export promotion policies, ease of regulatory framework, creating the necessary infrastructure for exports, and helping in identifying strategic recommendations for improving export competitiveness. Next question. Now, Niti Aayog, in collaboration with SCE, that is Singapore Cooperation Enterprise, and TeamSake Foundation, has organized the second phase of urban management program, that is for water recycling and reuse. So they said that 8 states and UTs are selected through a challenge method just to sell which of the following are not. Again, a keyword here is not among the 8 states. So guys, just few questions are left. Bug up. You have given lot of answers. Just wait for few seconds, few minutes, that we how much that few questions are left. And the answer here is, guys, that is Delhi. So Delhi is not the part among these 8 states. If I talk about the 8 states which have been chosen, they are Meghalaya, Punjab, UP, Chhattisgarh, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, and Puducherry. So these are the 8 states that have been chosen, and Delhi is not included. So Delhi is not a part of this initiative. Next question. Niti Aayog has launched the 4th edition of WTI, that is Women Transforming India Awards, and which of the following is the theme of this award? So tell me the theme of this Women Transforming India Awards. The answer is, that is Women and Entrepreneurship. So Women and Entrepreneurship is the theme of this Women Transforming India Awards. Next question, guys. Which of the following has conducted National Nutrition Survey? So tell me that which of the following body has conducted this National Nutrition Survey. Just one more question is left after this. So the answer is, guys, that is both 2 and 3. That is Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and UNICEF. They jointly have conducted this National Nutrition Survey. Moving on to the next question. I think this is the last question of this lecture. As per the Niti Aayog's annual report 2019-20, which of the following states is a leader in developing new and innovative solutions for renewable energy development? So guys, the right answer is, that is Karnataka. So Karnataka is a leader in developing new and innovative solutions for renewable energy development. So guys, that's all for today. If you have any query, you can email us at hello@edutap.co.in. You can even place us a call at 81462-07241. So guys, we are offering 50% off on our NABARD courses. You can avail this discount by using this code, that is NABARD50. And I wish you all best of the luck for your exam. Hope you get a great success, and bye bye, happy learning.